Lawrence of Cartesian algebras, these vinyl groups of two reflections. So it was the title official and also aided and later polarized base resurfaces with automorphic discrete. And the abstract, using our results about Lorentz and Cartesian algebras, and initiated the series. We give six series of examples of lattice polarized case resurfaces with automatic discriminant. And these are my joint results with Professor Gritsenko, and you can look our recent preprints. Year 16 and 17 for details. So let me start with introduction. So I will not give here definitions, I'm sure all of you know them, but later I will give definition. So so let me remind that for S polarized case series surface X, S is some even hyperbolic lattice. And there should be fixed some primitive embedding of this lattice S to Picard lattice SX, Picard lattice of K3. And we say that X is degenerate or belongs to discriminant for this S polarized if this element delta from orthogonal complement to S in Picard lattice, such that square is minus 2. And by geometry of K3 surfaces, it then follows that X has no polarization, H from F, just because this delta or minus delta will be effective and it will be contracted by H, which is prohibited to be polarization. And by global Torelli theory and epigraphicity of period map of K3, moduli of K3 surfaces are covered by corresponding Cervitian symmetric domains. And algebraic functions of moduli are the corresponding automorphic forms of these domains. And we call automorphic form discriminant form if support of zero divisor is is pre-image of the discriminant. The discriminant where K3 gets singular. And that this automorphic form is called automorphic. And for classical case when this lattice S is one dimensional, CH, H squared is equal to N, where N is positive, even. So for usual polarized K3 surfaces, this discriminant automorphic form exists for N equal to. So we know that discriminant is given by some algebraic function on coefficients. And actually later, Borchers constructed this discriminant as automorphic form. It's one of his well-known results. And I showed in 1995 that for infinite number of this even n, this discriminant automorphic form does not exist. And probably it was the first result in this direction. Not for all even, and because some people thought that it always exists such automorphic form which gives this discriminant. So I showed that actually for infinite number of n it doesn't exist. And later, Leyenda in 2003 showed that this discriminant automorphic form does not exist, and discriminant is not automorphic for all n which are greater than 2. So for all, we have a discriminant automorphic form and for n greater than 2, it doesn't exist. So in my talk, I ask about automorphic our joint results with Professor Gritsenko. So we what about automotive discriminants for S-polarized case resurfaces when this latest S is not one-dimensional by Rank, but Rank is greatly equal to 2. So it is introduction. Results which I will discuss here, they are based on our joint preprint with Professor Gritsenko, Lorentz and Katz-Mundi algebras, this wild group of two reflections. So it was in 2016, and very long preprint, 75 pages. So first, let me speak about some results of this preprint, and later I will use this result, and I also will give whole definition. So actually our purpose was to construct some Lorentz and Katz-Mundi algebra. So Lorentz here means hyperbolic, so we know the algebra is semi-simple for positive definite lattice, for the affine semi-positive definite, but we consider hyperbolic. And we require that denominator identity for the three algebra is automorphic form. Okay, and that will be related to this wide group of two reflections. So let me first speak about this example. So to construct such algebras, Lorentz and Katz-Mundi, we need first some even hyperbolic lattice, and I denote it S mirror. So mirror, later you will see that it is why it is related with mirror symmetry. So let me first recall that lattice means some non-degenerate integral symmetric bilinear form. So M means that M is free Z module of finite rank with symmetric Z integers by linear non-degenerate pairing x dot y for elements x, y from x. And also let me remind that M is hyperbolic if the corresponding symmetric bilinear form and then the R over R cross signature 1 positive square and N negative square. Where rank is of course N plus 1. And actually in our preprint with Gritsenko we choose different signature, N1 for algebras. But here my talk will be related to case resurfaces, algebraic geometry, and I choose this signature because for non-singular projective algebraic surfaces or we see we have the same signature for the Romsey-Mary lattice defined by the intersection of algebraic curves. And also let me remind that lattice M is even if x square xx is even for any x from M. And let me also remind you that we can relate to hyperbolic lattice M the cone. So it's called light cone, and later we shall use this. So it is called V of M, elements x from M to the R, such x squared is positive. And also I will use its half of V plus of M. So any two elements x, y from this V plus of M satisfy x, y is positive. So, of course, everybody knows this picture. X, this is this cone, V of M. So X has positive square. And it has two halves. So this will be V plus. And this will be E minus. why I choose this. And if you take two elements from one half, then x, y will be. And you can define the corresponding hyperbolic metric on Lobachevsky or hyperbolic space defined. Okay, so later I will use it. So also I will, so let me maybe go back a little bit. That actually here M means arbitrary hyperbolic lattice, but from our this preprint we have some list of this S mirror, this hyperbolic lattices, which we use to construct this Lorentzian Hartzmusi algebra. And we also need some special matrix, I don't know, U, which is defined by symmetric matrix, so 0, 1, 1, 0 in its basis. So this will be, of course, unimodular even, because determinant is minus 1. So unimodular means determinant is plus minus 1, even hyperbolic lattice of signature 1, 1. And also U of M means that we multiply 4 by M, M element for natural numbers. Okay, and later I will use the same notation, so this A in this NOS means lattice defined by integer symmetric matrix A in some basis. And the same notation U of M I will use for M of M, so it means that we have lattice, but we multiply form by m natural number. Or you can take rational also sometimes. So this notation I later will use. Okay. And using this S mirror, so it is hyperbolic lattice, and u of m it has signature 1, 1, and plus in the circle means orthogonal sum of lattices. And the obviously this T, U of M plus S mirror, it has signature 2 positive and N plus 1 negative squares if S mirror has signature 1 M. And this lattice T, this such signature defines so-called Hermitian symmetric domain of type 4. So omega of vector complex lines C omega from T tensor C such that omega square omega omega is zero and omega omega bar is positive. So of course it will be line because by this condition omega cannot be zero. So it is complex line. And last means that choice of one from two connected components of this omega, omega of t. There are two components. Or if you want, omega of t is quotient of omega tilde of t by c star, where omega tilde of t, you just forget c. Consists of elements omega from t tensor c side. Omega square is zero and omega omega bar is positive and also plus means connected components. And let me remind also that so now I give all definitions that holomorphic automorphic form phi of weight d natural number of this Hermitian symmetric domain omega of t means holomorphic homogeneous with respect to action of c star. Multiplication by C star function of the degree minus d, so here minus of this omega of t of t, which is symmetric with respect to some subgroup g from automorphic group of this lattice t, and plus means we take subgroup which of automorphic which sends the connected component to itself of finite integers. And this group is discrete and this automotive form defines some algebraic functions on the quote, on the block T by G, and this group is discrete on omega T and omega T of T, so it will be really some function. And and for some this hyperbolic lattices S mirror and some this M, so we use M to take this T U of M plus S mirror. We constructed in our preprint on this omega of T holomorphic, automorphic forms phi of some weight d from n with some remarkable properties. So they define actually this corresponding Hartzmudi algebras. And one of these remarkable properties is that, so I will emulate. Zero divisor of this automorphic form phi is union of so-called rational quadratic divisors d sub delta, which are orthogonal to elements delta from t square minus 2. So they are called, such elements are called minus 2 roots. And d delta is just all this complex line c omega from omega of t such that omega delta is 0. So it is orthogonal to delta. This also will be Hermitian symmetric domain, but codimension 1. And codimension 1, so it will be zero divisor of this automorphic form phi. And moreover, there's also very important multiplicities of this divisor, t delta ava. So let me repeat again that this automorphic form is remarkable because the zero divisor is just below this divisor. All components are perpendicular to this element delta square, delta is delta square minus. Okay, and multiplicity is out. Okay. And actually, we constructed six series. Later I will give them in six tables. So of this S mirror M and weight D of this automorphic form phi. So we constructed this way. So I will use notations which everybody knows. A phase, EN, N equals 6, 7, 8 are root lattices defined by the corresponding Dirichlet diagrams A, K, D, L, EN, where vertices corresponds to roots delta with delta square minus 2. And of course, these root lattices are negative definite, there are k, l, n respectively. Of course, everybody knows, for example, A3 is between that this delta square minus 2 and this means delta 1 delta 2 is 1, and this delta 3, delta 1 is 3. No, of course, we would not. Okay. And also, for lattice M, we denote by KM orthogonal sum of K copies of M. And so this is natural notation, and M of T means that we multiply form by T. Because I think now I gave all the definition. So because of this table, actually, I spoke on the using computer. So we have six tables. So later they will give S-polarized K-3 surfaces with automorphic distribution. So, for example, for this line, so S mirror will be U plus A1, and T will be U of M plus S mirror, and M is 1. And weight of automorphic form on Hermitian symmetric domain, this omega of T will be 35, and so on. So, So this first table U is unimodular and is unimodular, so this S mirror, and plus we add this lattice group lattice A1, O1, V2, 3, A1, and so on. Here A6, B6, and E6, A7, so for E6, weight will be, so for all these cases, M is 1. And the weight for this case will be E600 weight. Okay, this one exception. For this case, we take U not unimodular, but U multiplied by 2, plus 2 times T4, M is 1, and weight will be 28. And right hand side, I will explain later. So this is first table, second table. Will be so difference here is that we have here so also U, but this root lattice we multiply here by 2, by 3, by 4, and so on. And here U of M, M is 1. And weight for all the spaces is 12. Okay. And table 3. So these lattices are very, very concrete. So for 3, instead of U, we take one-dimensional lattice 2. So it has signature 1 positive square, and this is negative definite. So it will be hyperbolic.
But in the last row, you
Yeah. It is the exceptional case. Yes. So this case actually we added to here because it is will be related with important case in Richter's surfaces. Mobile surfaces. So this is Picard lattice of not in Richter's but double covering case 3 for in Richter's. This will be Picard lattice. Okay. So, case this table 4, difference is that here instead of U we take U of 2 or U of 4, so not unimodular. We have here M, 1, 2, 4, and here weight. So altogether, approximately there are 55 probably cases. And for this case, U of 4, and for last case, U of 3 instead of U. Okay. Okay. So there are very, very complete cases. Okay. So now we use all this. Lattices which appear in these tables for construction of lattice polarized case three surfaces with automorphic discriminant. And further, I will use results of my paper integer symmetric bilinear forms and some of their geometric applications, which was published in Dresden, a Russian journal in 1980. And it is quite long paper. And in this paper I developed some discriminant form technique for lattices. It was developed and I will use these results from this paper. Okay, so now we consider case 3. So let me remind, so we do the following. So we, in these tables we have this lattice T, which is signature 2 and some. So we consider, we take this lattice and we embed this lattice to unimodular lattice 3 times U plus 2 times T8. So it also has name AK3. And this is isomorphic to cohomology lattice, second cohomology for complex K3 surfaces. and it is even unimodular lattice of the signature 319. And let me remind that embedding of this lattice key to this lattice LK3 and always is called primitive if quotient has no torsion. So it is quotient will be free the module of rank 22 minus rank of t. And by result of this my paper, this primitive embedding really exists for all lattices from these tables, C6 tables. Okay. And we consider orthogonal complement S to this lattice T in this 3U plus 2 A. So S will be orthogonal complement. And and of course, S will be hyperbolic lattice. Because U has three positive squares, T has two positive squares, so orthogonal complement will have one positive square. And it is hyperbolic lattice of the rank 20 minus rank of this S-mirror. So, because T has 22. Okay. And so this is, and by, again, by results of this my paper, this lattice S is defined uniquely up to isomorphism. So for all primitive embeddings of T to this 3U plus 2E8, it is the same up to isomorphism. And it is calculated in the table. And also, my results of this my paper. Also, we can take orthogonal complement to this S. That orthogonal complement to S will be primitively embedded to 3U plus 2A. For all primitive embedding, will be also the same, and it will be this T. So U of M plus S mirror. So we have here, we now have returned to this. Tables, so, so actually in these tables we calculated the orthogonal complement, for example, u plus e1, orthogonal complement will be u plus e8 to t plus e7. And here also in the right side I show so called discriminant form of this lattice S. So it is formed on S star quotient S. And I showed in this paper that this discriminant form and signature, they define genus of the lattice. And here there are result calculation of genus in notation by Conway and Sloan. The book Sphere Patterns, Lattices in Groups. So I actually I don't have time to explain. And also another result is that all these lattices S are actually unique in their genus. So they are unique for this signature correspondence and for this discriminant form. Unique up to isomorphism. So this right hand side is calculation of this S. So we don't open. And for some cases, actually, it is not easy to calculate. So, for example, this lattice means that orthogonal complement, we should take u of 4 in bad primitive to u plus e8, and then take orthogonal complement. And it is also uniquely defined, or maybe uniquely defined for some, the sum of these lattices. So you can embed primitively how you want, but the result will be the same. Okay. So we have this calculation. Okay. So now we have this lattice this hyperbolic vertex is S also. So we have S mirror and we have S. So now let me remind you that crazy surfaces, projectives are, so for this my talk where I consider projective algebraic surfaces, because it's possible to consider Hilbertian or complex. So K3 is projective algebraic surface over C with trivial canonical class Kx, and irregularity u dimension of omega 1 is 0. So because everybody knows from this canonical class, so then H2 0 of x will be, or omega 2 of x will be C omega x, where an x omega x is non-zero two-dimensional holomorphic form with zero devices. It is defined uniquely after multiplication by element from C. And also the correlates of x is just we take H2 and intersects with H11 or just elements x from H2 of x. Such that x is perpendicular to h2 0 of x, to 0 of x, which is o omega x. And Picard-Lucas Sx is hyperbolic of rank less than equal 20, and cohomology lattice of K3 would be 3u plus 2a. So it is even unimodular lattice of signature 319. And it is unique up to isomorphic. And so now let us take x one of this even hyperbolic lattices S from this table. Or actually just any, for example, any lattice S from tables, its tables. So let me remind you that this result is X is called S polarized, S polarized. If some primitive embedding S to Picard lattice Sx of K3 is fixed such that S contains ample plus H in S for K3. And for general S polarized K3 surfaces, Picard lattice will be just this S. And for arbitrary K3X, we have that this orthogonal complement for S in Sx does not have elements delta with square minus 2, because by Riemann-Roch theorem plus delta or minus delta is effective, and then it will be contracted by this H, but H is ample, it is polarization, so it is impossible. So now let me remind us my global Torelli theorem for K3 surfaces X is defined by periods which give a point in this omega of t. So omega of t, so so H2 0 of X is C omega X, it is line in T tends C, and T, so S perpendicular, is transcendental lattice of S polarization. So this will be and by definition H2 0 of X cannot belong to this rational quadratic divisor d delta from omega of t or delta from t with square minus 2, because delta belongs to orthogonal complement by global Torelli theorem and epimorphicity of the period where for K3 we don't have the moduli space of S polarized K3 surfaces. Is maybe requires some more geometry. Is just we should take this Hermitian symmetric domain omega of t, and we should delete this rational quadratic divisors orthogonal elements with square minus 2 from there. And this will be modular. And G is subgroup of finite integers. And this subset union of this rational quadratic divisors orthogonal to elements from delta from t square minus 2, and its quotient is called discriminant. So phi is equal to 0 exactly on this m phi, which we construct this forms, they are equal to 0 exactly on the discriminant. And so finally we came to final that for this our K3 discriminant is automorphic and phi is discriminant automorphic form. So we obtain K3 with automorphic discriminant. Just because I told of this phi by our construction with Professor Gritzenko, it is equal to 0 exactly on this rational quadratic devices orthogonal to elements with square minus 2. So all because of these considerations, and so all this latex is S, so let me repeat. So this latex is S mirror we get from our paper with Witzel. So we take this U of M plus S mirror and we construct form this automorphic form of this E. Symmetric domain, and we take orthogonal complement, and we take S-polarized spaces, S-polarized spaces, surfaces with orthogonal discriminant. Okay. And of course it is thought it is actually, of course in this our preprint, work preprint is when we mentioned this the same construction, but here just I gave all details. And of course it is interesting to understand the geometric meaning of this automorphic form. And I just will mention that there are results by Gritzenko, Kulik, Sankaran, that if this discriminant automorphic form phi exists and the weight of this phi is big with respect to multiplicities of divisors of phi, so for our case it is 1, then the modular space of K3 S polarized is uniruled. So uniruled, probably it was mentioned already in the lecture by Ruhka, so let me just to be sure and remind that uniruled means that the algebraic variety V is uniruled if we have dominant rational F P1 multiplied by some another variety W and rational, and dimension of W is equal to dimension of V minus 1, and this is all variation. So now let me try to explain the meaning of this hyperbolic lattice S mirror, which was used for the construction of this T. So we construct this K3 using this transcendental lattice. Or in the Picard lattice, we take this orthogonal form. So what is meaning of this S mirror? Actually, this latest S mirror hyperbolic. So it is hyperbolic, and it also defines what now S mirror polarized base resurfaces. So which can be considered as mirror symmetric to S polarized base resurfaces with automorphic discriminant. And they have another remarkable property. So there exists element rho of S mirror tensor Q, such that rho square is greater or equal to zero, and for all non-singular rational curves E on K3X. With Picard-Lattice's S mirror, we have that rho E is 1. So let me remind that square of rational curves always is minus 2. And if, so for this, all non-singular rational curves with respect to this rho are lines. And if rho square is positive, actually the this case also here, then all non-singular rational curves are lines with respect to this polarization rho. So T rho belongs to S mirror from SX for some T from N. And the set of such lines is finite, and automorphic group of K3 is also finite. So we get K3 such that all non-singular rational curves are lines, and because they are perpendicular to elements, not perpendicular for this condition, their number is finite.
But you said that rho is rational, yeah? So they are not really lines.
Lines in this sense. So if you multiply rho by t, so then it belongs to Picard-Lattice. So all non-singular rational curves have the same degree for this element of the atom, but it will be careful. And the set of such lines is finite, and automorphic group of K3 is also finite, because this actually all the hyperbolic lattices SX with finite automorphic group X were found in my paper. Papers and for rank of SX equal to 4 by Winkler. And number of this lattices SX is finite if rank is greater or equal to 3. And for rank 2 and 1, it is already known. So actually, in our construction with Gritsenko, we take just this finite set of this lattices S, then we calculated when we can find this element rho with this condition. And then we calculated this from this lattice T for some S mirror plus U of MN constructed automorphic. Okay. So you can see here some similarity. So for this automorphic form phi, which we constructed, is related to model B moduli of S polarized case surfaces, and to model, because this automorphic form phi is on transcendental lattice. And model A curves the carnalities of S mirror polarized case surfaces. And we call this mirror symmetry as arithmetic mirror symmetry. So let me maybe give more details. So here similarity is that for this mirror symmetry, for model B, this automorphic form gives automorphic discriminant, and for model A, curves become lattices, it gives polarization such that all rational curves have to be one. So let me maybe give more details. So this automorphic form phi can be written as phi of z, where z is some variable, where z belongs to this so-called complexified light cone, omega of b plus of s mirror. So it is sum of s mirror tensor r into this hyperbolic plus square root of minus 1, this cone, b plus of s mirror. So it is like similar to upper cuff plane for dimension 1. So it is called the complexified cone of this s mirror. And for t, which is u of m plus s mirror, so transcendental lattice of k3. The domain omega of t can be, so which describes moduli of k3, can be identified with this complexified light cone omega of b plus of s mirror as follows. So that we should take basis of this lattice u for matrix which I written with the matrix which I written. Yeah, we identify the element z from this complexified light cone, this complex line from this Hermitian symmetric domain omega of t, where omega z is z square e1 divided by 2 and e2 divided by m plus z. So it will be element of this omega tilde t. And so using this variable, we can write this automorphic form phi by Fourier expansion. And Fourier coefficients of this automorphic form phi, where exponents are labeled by this lattice S mirror, they define generators of this Katz-Mudi algebra G, so which is some Li super algebra. And G is actually graded by this S mirror. So you can see that this mirror symmetry is actually ruled by this algebra G, which is surely related to some physics. Okay. So let me give more details. Okay. So this automorphic form phi with this variable that z, which I explained, it has Fourier expansion which gives denominator identity of this V algebra. So phi of z can be written as sum by W element of while group, determinant of W, here exponent, so W act n, minus this m of a exponent here. So it is Fourier expansion. So where all coefficients m of a are integral, and it also has infinite product expansion, so-called vortex product. So phi of z can be written using this rho, which I explained, product, here 1 minus exponent, and some numbers, so they are called multiplicities of alpha. So here I should explain what does it mean W. So W means that so this coefficient they give so-called multiplicities of roots of multiplicities of alpha of roots this V algebra G. And here delta plus is contained in S mirror. And together this is sum and this is product, they give so-called denominator identity of this V algebra. And now let me explain this W, what is W. So W is just group generated by reflections S delta in all elements delta from S mirror. This square equal to minus 2. And so they are all two reflections. And M, which I also used for this Fourier expansion is the fundamental chamber of this for this group W. And of course this reflection means that it sends delta to minus delta and on orthogonal complement it is identity. So it is given by just by this formula. S delta of x is x plus x delta delta for x from S mirror. So now I think I explained everything. And Lorentz, so it is hyperbolic, automorphic, Schatzmodi-Li. So she is actually not just algebra, it is super-Li algebra. Is defined by generators and defining relations, which are given by this integer Fourier coefficients M of A of this Fourier expansion. I should call it back. So this automorphic formula has sum and M of A, they divide, so these are integral numbers, integers. And they define generators of Schatzmodi algebra and defining relations of this Schatzmodi algebras. Sorry, I think I don't have time to explain. And this multiplicities of alpha they give, so it is graded by this latest S mirror by elements alpha from S mirror, and so this, it is sum of J alpha, alpha belong from S mirror, infinite sum, and multiplicity of alpha gives dimension of the J alpha. Of this grading. So it is appears in this worksheet problem. And this reflection group W is called the Weyl group of this least super algebra automorphic regime. And you can find details about this construction of this Lie algebras in our meeting with Vincent, which I mentioned. So Lorentz and Schatzmodi algebras with Weyl groups of two different shapes. I think I almost finished. So of course it will be interesting to find some other similar examples, and it is difficult job. So here actually. So I finished just about the finish of the statements. So the statements give very nice space resonances, which have very beautiful geometry. They have, if you consider this three is depolarization, that all minus two curves, non-singular rational, have the same degree with respect to some polarization. But if you consider case 3 with this Picard lattice, then they have automorphic discriminant, and which is given by this automorphic group. And we have around 55 such examples. Okay.
Questions? What is the meaning of this integer M in the construction?
M. Actually, for classical veracity, which appears, for example, for this 14 Arnold exceptional singularities, unimodular 14, it is just, was first example of veracity M is 1. So we take U of 1, so unimodular. But just this example shows that to take U of M is also possible. No, from my point of view, you know, this decomposition, it fixes some, because moduli of case 3 with this zero elements of this lattice, they correspond to give points at infinity of moduli. So they give some cusp of moduli. And we can take M equal 1 or 2.
Can you understand which M should you take if you just know S mu?
There are examples for the same lattice S mirror when we have U and when we have U of 2. So it is possible to have. So they just give different casts at infinity of modulo. For example, you see this example. So this.
Yeah, you have the same lattice.
So this is the same, but here we take U of 1 plus this lattice. Here we take U of 2. And the weight of this automorphic form is different. And also, Picard lattice of this mirror precedent. So here will be U of 2 plus EA plus D4, but here it will be U plus 3 times D4. And let me maybe also look at this example of which was actually considered by Borchardt. So this is Picard lattice U of 2 plus EA of 2 Picard lattice of V3, which is double coloring of the lattice surface. And this U plus EA of 2 plus here U of 2 is transcendental lattice of this V3 with this Picard lattice. So we just take this example. It was it is very classical, and just now preprint we don't have this example, but some people asked us where are Enriquez? So because Enriquez